Filipino actress Liza Soberano makes her Hollywood debut in the romantic horror comedy Lisa Frankenstein. A resident movie critic, Manny the Movie Guy, tells us what he thinks.
I talked to him.
I wish I was with you.
Catherine Newton stars in the title role as Lisa, a goth-like high school outcast who's in love with a corpse born 1837. Then one evening, Lisa is smitten, cold sprouts the creature is perplexed, and you'll be as confused as the corpse in this derivative film written by Diablo Cody, who won an Oscar for writing Juno.
I can't believe you're here.
Director Zelda Williams, Robin Williams' daughter, makes her feature film debut, and her uneasiness as a first-time director shows. She could not find the perfect tone to blend the macabre and the romantic comedy aspects of the script.
Did you smash the mirror in the bathroom?
And it's too bad because she has a great cast, especially Carla Gugino as Lisa's stepmother and Liza Soberano, our Capamilia, making her Hollywood debut. She stars as Taffy, Lisa's popular stepsister, and the screen lights up every time she's on. She understood the assignment.
Lisa.
Michael.
Lisa Frankenstein takes the best parts from other films, the candy-colored campiness of the John Waters movies, the tortured soul of Edward Scissorhands, and the central theme of Heathers. Throw in a little natural-born killers and mix it with today's sensibilities, and you'll get a film that truly doesn't know what it is.
Yeah.
It's a good thing the movie has a short runtime and the supporting cast is game. It's a bit violent, but for all its blood, it lacks passion and soul. But if you love those teenage angst movies masquerading as goth thrillers, then by all means, watch Lisa Frankenstein. But please, do stay for Liza Soberano, a knockout in her breakthrough role. And for that, Lisa Frankenstein gets 2.5 out of 4 stitched together kisses. And getting a major re-release is Disney Pixar's Turning Red. Originally planned for a worldwide theatrical release, the film went straight to the Disney Plus streaming service in March of 2022 due to the pandemic. It even received a nomination for Best Animated Feature at the 95th Academy Awards.
All about that hustle, am I right?
I enjoyed this heartwarming tale about growing up, and you can fall in love with the funny and sweet Turning Red on the big screen all over again. I'm Manny the Movie Guy for ANC.
I'm a gross red monster!
In sports, the Kansas City Chiefs produce some overtime magic to repeat as Super Bowl champions. Our North America Bureau correspondent Steve Angeles now joins us with a wrap of the NFL championship game. Stevie, over to you.
Yes, Carmina, it took nearly 5 quarters, yes, an overtime game that lasted almost the whole overtime period, but the Kansas City Chiefs have won their third Super Bowl in about 7 years or so, and first time in 19 years that an NFL team has won back-to-back. It was a very stout defensive game with a few turnovers, one trick play touchdown, but in the end, Kansas City managed to come back, being down by as much as 10 points throughout the game, but it was Patrick Mahomes in the end engineering a couple of game-tying touchdown drive towards the end of regulation, and then eventually, despite the 49ers' drive to get a field goal in overtime, Mahomes brought down the team for the touchdown. The final score was 26-19, of course, for Filipinos. One of the big highlights of the game was we all knew that Usher was going to perform at the Super Bowl, but we had no idea that he would be pulling out a whole parade of stars, including our one Phil M. Pride, multi-Grammy winning artist. And I know, Carmina, she was one of your Double Nation guests before her. So for Cyril, this was overall a great Super Bowl. Of course, took place in Las Vegas and lots of fanfare. Looks like we have a dynasty, a show to talk about, and some stars in the making, and of course, a lot of Taylor Swift sightings throughout. Carmina?
All right, Steve, you're right about that. She was a teeny tiny little girl when I interviewed her way before when we had that show, Adobo Nation, but now look at her. Really proud of her. Thanks again, Steve.
It's everything.
We can't bid goodbye to the NFL season without taking a look at the so-called Taylor Swift effect. Since her football Sunday debut in September, NFL viewership and merch sales went through the roof. For starters, Swift's love story with Travis Kelce generated about $300 million in brand value for the Chiefs and the league. And when they say Swifties are a force to be reckoned with, they're not wrong. Over 200 million Americans are expected to have watched the Super Bowl, blowing away the 115 million record last year, thanks in part to her attendance. She also made daughters bond with their fathers over football.
My dad sent it to me as sort of just I mean, he sort of sent it to me on an offbeat, but I didn't tell him I entered. So then when I got, I guess, the notification where they followed me on Instagram, they told me I won, I called him immediately, and I was like, guess who's going to the Super Bowl? And he's like, Taylor Swift? I said, no, you're going. And it was just a really surreal moment, I guess, yeah.
We've always been close, and so this is just another aspect, another moment that we can share together. And just the fact that it's Taylor Swift on her side, I like Taylor as well.
Well, love her or hate her, there's no denying everything Taylor touches turns to gold.